Hello everyone, this is Nick and I'm with Love, and we're going to do a commentary on the MAT game between Bohemian Grove and Bible Balance.
What's up? Let's go.
So you were actually on the Bohemian Grove team, weren't you?
Yeah, I was Flagger.
Okay, so you're Untilted.
Yep, appropriate name.
You guys had, this build you're telling me about with the three allies, Ranger and Dervish.
Yeah, kind of decided this main team composition like last minute.
So this was a Crypt Shot, Ranger, Lightning Surge, and what? It was Mind Shock, yeah. And Mind Burn on split.
But we didn't have any utility on the Lightning, so we had Res.
Oh, you had Res. You didn't have. You mean the Lightning Surge or the Mind Shock?
The Lightning Surge.
Wow. Okay, so he could like not even 1v1 a Necro all that safely.
Yeah, not at all. I don't think that mattered much, but you'll see.
Okay, and Core is running just standard Necro balance with Dervish and Axe Warrior. Nothing out of the ordinary.
They're actually going to defend like very aggressively with 2 damage.
Okay, they're running for the next lag on the Necro right now. So, got 3 guys hovering around the base with the Ranger, Necro, and Monk.
Yeah.
Necro getting really, really close to dying right there.
Yeah, that was really close.
They could have actually killed him if they went in a little bit earlier.
Yeah, then they used 2 damage to defend our 2 allies.
Okay, and you guys were sending 3 on split as well?
Well, yeah, I just decided to go because I thought we could, like, win this 3v3 and get some NPCs or some kills. But that didn't happen.
So you guys running flag on Ellie right now. While looks like Cora is not running a flag yet.
They just say
fuck. But they're running flag now.
Yeah.
So this Crypt Shot Ranger is going to do a lot of work. Core doesn't really have a way to run the flag. Well, they defend with Necro and Ranger. So this is actually really good for you guys.
It's good, but it's not going to achieve much.
It's not going to achieve much unless you can get NPCs down.
Yeah, that's the thing. But I think our Ellie's could have played a bit more risky. Like, go through the doors, maybe. I don't know.
Yeah, it's really hard for a Necro and a Ranger to kill you guys, so you could play basically as risky as you want as long as you don't get snared and collapsed in.
Yeah.
Look at this though, the Ranger is having, like, not even able to get the Dervish a little bit low. I guess Poison wasn't up there for a while, but...
Yeah, that's true, I guess.
It's very non-threatening, the push from Crypt Shot Ranger. It takes forever, even if you cripple him the whole way, it takes forever to get him low. So you guys send the Monk back to main now. Came back to main, so that means that the Necro came back to main as well for their team.
Yeah, I was just basically following their, like, 4th damage all game. And we were already, like, quite ahead on flag.
So is this a 28-minute game?
Yeah. It is.
Are you guys bringing another flag on Ellie? Really firing other flags now.
Yep.
So the apply gets taken out on your team. So this Ellie's really not able to get anything down, even with the Ranger not even really defending them right now. Still not able to go.
Well, they're staying out of the doors, and so, like, they're basically never in range of the flagger, so.
They got Archer down now.
Yeah, because they split, like, that was good, I guess.
They really need to be getting more out of this, though, because the Rangers literally just ran out of the base all the way around into the gate locks, and they got only one Archer for it.
Do you think, like, 2 Ellies can score kills or get NPC through Ranger and Monk?
Yeah, it's especially with Tenaya's. You guys are running Tenaya's, so you're probably doing a blind on this mine shock. But it should be really easy if you guys get kills, but it can be hard if the allies don't usually play this kind of build. Like, for people that don't usually play this kind of build, it's really hard. It takes some good experience and coordination to do it properly.
Yeah. See how far ahead on flags we were, like...
Yeah. When... But you can't punish them for it, because you don't have a mesmer.
Felt like it didn't really matter.
Yeah, like, they were even just holding on Dervish right there, and you guys couldn't do anything about it. I guess you guys were waiting to run next leg on your Dervish.
Yeah.
So that's why
I couldn't do it. Put so much emphasis on being ahead on flags, but actually, it didn't really matter. Maybe we could have tried, like, to 8v8 more when we were that ahead.
Yeah, I mean, your allies just need to find ways to get the NPCs down. In a 28-minute game, you can always find ways to get NPCs down. Even if you can't win the 2v2, you can, like, as long as you're not in threat of getting killed by splitting, you can always just run back and forth until you get a tiny bit of an opening and get some NPCs from it.
Yeah. Like, collapsing one alley with this build doesn't achieve much, I feel like, because, like, without a Mesmer and a Cryptshot Ranger, you just don't have enough damage to power through two monks with 4 damage.
Yeah, exactly. But you guys have a lot of movement control, though, with, like, all the knockdowns with the ice and the cripples from the Dervish and Ranger. You have so much movement control that you could just be literally running back and forth from middle to the base, and you guys would be able to get NPCs down, like, pretty easily like that, I feel.
Basically have to, like, get their flagger away from their base and then just place there while snaring him.
Yeah, exactly.
Because their flaggers spend their fucking game in their base, basically.
Yeah, trading one for one with the flagger while you have a build that can't score any kills on main team is just not very good. Like, trading with the flagger is good if you have a main team composition that can kill, but you guys don't. You have a main team composition that pushes flag, so there's no point trading one for one. You're in their base with the flagger.
Right, so what we try to do is, like, actually try to have their prot go back and then, like, snare it with the ranger and collapse our allies. Work at some point, like, only once, but it's like, it's complicated because, really,
So you guys have got a nice collapse up right now. The fire Ellie is collapsed to the main team and is very far ahead of... Actually, no, he's not. Actually, my bad. The heal monk is... the flag monk is already there, so... Necro waiting in there. Yeah. I think this is the only situation where you guys can really... You can actually lose the game. Like...
Yeah, but like...
In an AV8 like this.
At that point, we could have rushed our 2 LEs in their base and sneaked our flagger and probably get, like, NPCs.
Yeah, your crypt shot just got diverted as well, so that'll slow you guys down a bit.
Yeah.
It's, like, one of the biggest weaknesses of crypt shot. It's so easy to divert, complicate, rupt, remove, like...
Yeah, I guess. Yeah.
I mean, it can do good when they have to run the flag on Dervish that whole route through the crypt shot, but most of the time, I just feel like it's not optimal. I mean, if they defend you with a Ranger and a Necro, so they have to run on Dervish and don't have any way to, you know, stop the push very well, then yeah, I can see the Crypto working there, but a really smart team could just defend with Mesmer and Monk, like, against 3 people. So then you would still be able to run the flags probably, because you'd have the Necro able to run flags, which would destroy the Crypto Ranger. So I mean, there are ways to get around
just
it.
Just Monk and Ranger, to be honest.
Yeah, but that wouldn't usually work there. Only really in this game.
Yeah. Like, now we got 3 damage in their base, kind of. I don't know.
Yeah, this is a very strange setup.
I think that's when we are able to, like, snare the prot and collapse on the main team. Because the prot is in the ice here, and he's gonna get, like, shit on by the Crypt Shot.
Yeah, that's a good point. Yeah, this is a very nice collapse. This position is perfect to collapse on. Like, when they push up on you, on your flag running, like, it's really easy to collapse on Frozen when you do that.
Like, look at the pro. Like, yeah, he's getting snared, but he's gonna be, like, only leaves it like a 5 second window to get a kill.
Yeah.
And I think we're actually gonna get a kill on the Mesmer. Because the spike is, like, so insane with Tenai's and the two Ellie's, but.
Almost killed the Hillmonk there as well.
Yeah.
But now the full team's there.
Yeah. We're still, like, completely ahead on flag.
I think your poison got taken out there. So yeah, you guys have, like, look at their bars. Every single one of their bars is at full health, basically.
Yeah.
So there's really no way to win this AV8. You guys are just waiting to take a death on this Ellie holding the flag. So I think the collapse is nice, but you have to sort of break it off a bit earlier.
Yeah, probably. But it's like, once the prop understood that we're just going to try to catch him out of position, like, he's way more careful, and it becomes increasingly harder to do that, like, that kind of move. Because honestly, like, you could almost let our Cryptshot Ranger go in their base.
Yeah, I think he could, because, you know, the Cryptshot is just so non-threatening. It's such low DPS that you can just leave it for such a long time. You don't even have to follow it even close to it with the promo. Like, if you just put up Life Siphon on it as the Necro, it would take, like, 3 minutes to kill you.
Probably, yeah. So, like, 10 minutes, we basically achieved, like, just one death on their Mesmer. Which is not very good.
Well, it's still more than never achieved, I guess. The problem is, though, that they can achieve a lot in a very short period of time. I feel like a lot easier than you guys can, if you guys play like this. Because, like, they have so much more damage and so much more ability to kill than you guys that they can make, you know, a mountain out of a molehill where you guys just struggle
well,
to...
Well, we still have tons of damage, but it doesn't seem to... Like, we have 3 Ellie's and a Dervish. That's, like, still a lot of damage.
Yeah.
But, like, no enchant removal is really, I feel...
People used to sometimes take Rend on, like, the Dervish, or you could take it on the Ranger or something as well, but a build without any enchant removal at all is... makes things kind of difficult sometimes. Promark nearly going down here. Ooh, nice draw at the last second for Morphe.
Yeah.
That was nice because the Promark can't, like, defend himself when he's by himself, right? I think he also just used Shield Guardian, so he might not even have... Well, he either doesn't have Spirit Point or Aegis, I think. So he does a Shroud one, so maybe just another Aegis, but yeah, the Promonk does not have very good defense when he's by himself.
Yeah. So maybe Claude's, like, trying to catch him with our Ellie's could be good.
Well, usually a Melshot Ranger could make short work of a Promonk, which doesn't have Wrath just because of the degen they can't get off.
Yeah.
Or a Necro would do that as well. Like, Necros can solo prop monks if they're too much trouble.
I actually wanted to, like, take a Necro over the L Surge. But, yeah, it didn't happen. I mean,
the advantage of the L Surge would be that you can push flags with it and, you know, have a much stronger map presence. The advantage in the Necro would be you can sort of have a stronger AV8 or a stronger 5v5 or 6v6.
Yeah. It's also stronger because... lower damage, I think. I don't know.
But not having a self heal on the Ellie feels to me like it takes away a lot of the advantage of having the Ellie in the first place.
Yeah. I didn't even know that prior to going into the game. I think we're gonna get NPCs just by basically pushing our third on the knights.
the flag game is kind of even now. Like, neither team really has an advantage. You guys are getting a nice... Of course, you might get an NPC off this. Maybe.
No. Their flaggers already, like...
Oh, your arrow really stopped. Ah, the lightning surge, yeah. The lightning surge stopped, by the way.
Like, I don't really know what the fuck we were trying to do at that point. We were just taking tons of damage at main team with, like, zero damage, supporting our monks, except our derv, and, like, not doing anything in return then, so.
So you caught the pro monk out again, but it's pretty hard to kill it with.
Is he? Yeah. Are we gonna collapse? Yeah, it looks like it.
Sorry, I missed that. We'll, you guys took a death on the front. Yeah, so, like, as soon it's as they got a little bit of a flag advantage.
Yeah, we didn't realize that trading one for one with the flag, it was really not effective.
You had a Necro or a Mesmer, definitely could be. Quora's not really able to get much more out of this, though.
Yeah, I don't know, we somehow survived here for, like, longer than we should.
Yeah, this is a amazing spot for Core to be in right now. They have all the damage together, and they have a flag advantage. And you guys have a guy dead. Yeah, this is the perfect spot for them. If I was them, I would be trying to just push into your Lord Pit right now.
Yeah, actually. And they could even maybe sit in our, like, knights and stuff, just because, like, we have... Little kill pusher without a mesmer, I don't know.
Quaz Ranger is now running around map trying to follow one of the allies around.
Yeah, it's pretty hard for them to prevent us from splitting.
Yeah, I guess Quaz is just kind of playing it a bit safe.
Yep.
Trying to make sure they don't lose any NPCs. I would have probably traded NPCs. I would have probably been like, just let the dervish or the Ellie split. And, you know, if they split two guys and take out a couple of NPCs, who cares? As long as you take out their team, basically. Because you won't get a better spot as core than you have right now.
Yeah, that's as good as it gets for them.
Oh, like you had a minute ago when all your damage was together.
I don't really know how we're gonna get out of this. Like, we're just gonna push them out, I guess.
Yeah, they're not taking control of gate locks at all, so you guys can sort of choose to run out the back door and kind of get punished for it.
We have, like, four damage here, and we have only one, and... I'm scared of our ranger wiping their team.
Yeah, that's a good point. You guys could be pushing knights, like, for half the game with your dervish. Especially when the Ellie runs flag, you could just, like, they have nothing to defend the dervish with, right? You guys have nothing to defend the dervish with, I mean,
if your Ellie's running.
Sorry, I mean, yeah, they could push their dervish through. As soon as you run flag in Ellie, just rush their dervish into your knights, and you guys have nothing to defend with.
Well, we'd have to collapse our Ellie's, but it's a pretty long route, so...
Yeah. Oh, dervish actually got pretty low there, running the flag. You guys will double run this there. She'll get you back ahead on flags.
And they boosted, so... We basically... They neglected all the DP they had. So we're back to square one.
Yeah.
God damn it.
They're even catching these monks out of position. Like, Core have... Spirit Bond on Flag and Prod Monk, so even if you catch people out of position, it's so hard to kill them.
Yeah. Yeah, that was, I mean, except for really good collapse, like, when catching the fuse alone, like, there's no way we should have tried, like, to kill them. We should have gone for NPCs.
The front door right now is so open. Like, close front door is so open while they run a necro.
I think we're gonna actually push in now. Yeah.
Yeah, like, while they run a necro, like, it's perfect position to just rush through the front door. Like, the biggest problem with running in split defense is you can't defend split while you're doing it.
Yeah, that's pretty... Yeah, we're gonna get a knife for it, and like, our ranger should be snaring the upfront now. Almost.
Yeah. Well, Holly's nearly going down on the ice, so I think it'll be fine there.
I'm almost gonna get soloed by this dervish, like, like so much damage, like, the fuck. We're getting one knight for that, which is good.
Oh, that was close.
Oh, he could have saved it. Yeah, that was so close. I feel like when their prod is not main though, and they have like flag or infuse, we could just maybe kill them with our 4 damage.
At 19?
Yeah, well actually, never mind. Our ranger was pushed up, so we only had 3 damage.
Oh, we got that knight?
The second knight.
Wow, that was like, close. That was so close. That was
pretty close. That would have helped us like tremendously.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, it's 20 minutes and you guys only really have one knight down. With the
yeah,
build,
we have one knight down.
Should be able to get these impetus down so easily.
They all have 10%, except their mesmer, which is 5 maybe.
So you guys getting other claps up here, but can you get a kill from it? Nope. Almost
close.
Though, that was really close.
Maybe we shouldn't spike the fuse because he's got dark escape.
Well, I mean, without the sort of the KDs other than Mind Shock, which has to be on the spike target, it's kind of hard for you to spike anything that isn't a healer, I would assume. Because you can't really shut down healers while you're spiking.
We were actually pretty late on flag at that point.
Yeah, there are full flag ahead and more. The front door right now is—it's so open to a rush with the Holly here next to the Crypt Shot. I mean, that's another problem with Crypt Shot is that you can just predict the Crypt Shot with your Mentouch, and then he'll never be able to Crypt Shot you. I guess Holly just ate one there and got his Mentouch erupted.
Yeah. Well, that's the only case.
But yeah, they're actually getting an archer out of this, or at least. Yeah, it looks like they'll get this archer. Oh, actually didn't get the archer, sorry. There was a Stark down here. I should have got the archer there.
Yeah. I mean, that archer is not even... Who the fuck cares about that archer?
Yeah, but it would be nice to get something at least.
Yeah. You have like 4 damage pushed in their base right now. And we're just not doing anything. There's a solo monk here against like 3 of our damage. Well, they have all their monks here.
Necro is... Oh, they actually have the flag up here the whole time. What the hell was that about? Like, I didn't understand how that happened. I guess nobody saw the flag. Yeah, I mean, he dropped it here when you guys were a flag up before. Like, I saw that happen, but you guys didn't return it when you cut before.
Yeah, he was just... Yeah.
I mean, I guess that's easy to miss because you don't expect it, but that's pretty funny. Your ranger... You're getting a... little bit of an opening in their base. I guess not really.
Ranger doesn't have enough like kill power just to kill an NPC in like 10 seconds.
Yeah. They have 2 monks over here against 2 damage. You guys could maybe score a kill somewhere else. I mean, the heal monk is by himself. Cause
he's
mask.
Got no damage on him though.
Where's the damage in your team? They're pushing knights, I guess.
I don't know. In their base, we're all in their base at that point.
Oh, they might get the knight. Come on.
Yeah, we're getting the knight. We're getting the knight, I think. Oh my god, that was so fucking close. But I think we're gonna get it.
Maybe it's pretty hard to get without an enchant removal again, though. Like,
well, they have two monks here, so yeah.
You guys are losing your knights.
Yeah, and that was really bad.
This is like all it takes, though, is just one push when the other team isn't ready for it. And then those knights are down. Nope. Like,
that was really well played from their derv.
Yeah.
And now we're collapsing and closing doors on him. But the move was good, but he took ages. Like, because their healer is cool.
This is such a mess.
Yeah.
Such a confusing situation.
We had the opportunity to like lock their two monks behind the doors and collapse on the one monk in our base. But we fucking failed it. Oh, we have an Ellie free alone in their base now? Oh no, there's the Necro here. Shit.
This is such a strange composition here. So you're defending with one of the split alleys, the Mind Shock, and with the Lightning Surge.
And yeah, that's monks. Like a bad combo. But I think they would have died, because we're not going to remain like that, actually. I don't think they could push our base now and survive with just one monk.
Well, your Ellie looks like he's trying to leave.
Yeah, he's leaving.
So this is a terrible decision, because it means that you can't stop them from pushing him fit if he leaves.
Yeah, exactly. So we end up like, yeah, 4 damage in their base. But like, they can keep their 3 damage on our lord and we can't do it.
Oh, the Ellie has Spirit Bond. Your Mind Shock has Spirit Bond.
Yeah.
That explains a lot. That explains why you guys couldn't sort of win or couldn't fight confidently at the back for most of the game, because you can't really fight into the Ranger or the Necro, because your only healer is Heal Breeze. You don't patient.
Yeah.
So that explains a lot, I guess.
So now they're on a Lord, and we didn't even start.
But you guys just can't do anything about this. Like, there's no point for this Ellie to even be here right now, because you're not gonna kill them.
Yeah, maybe you should have just YOLO'd and rushed in their base.
Yeah, I think that would have been like your only option. He's not even slowing down the damage, really.
And us in their base, like, we're taking tons of pressure, because they actually have Necro and Ranger. They were prodding the Lord, though.
Yeah, well, you guys got the bodyguard down somehow, which was a huge benefit to you, I guess.
Yeah. But that's like, our Ellie's were so low energy. It's just getting stripped and recharge.
Yeah, Ranger Necro defense is so strong for 28.
Yeah.
Well, let's see who won this.
Yeah, that was some pretty bad splitting.
Yeah, pretty good. Oh, I wish I'd seen earlier that you guys had Spirit Bond instead of Patient Spirit. That would have, made things make a lot more sense. Alright, thank you everyone for watching, and see you later.